For 10,000 years, Koreans have developed their language and culture on one peninsula. Korea is blessed with four distinctive seasons and a landscape of endless beauty. Its people have long cultivated their mentality through combining nature and the arts. Through the hands that play musical instruments, guide the tips of a paintbrush, or bodies with graceful dance moves, Koreans have always had a flair for balancing passion and moderation. Glimpse the lifestyle of traditional Koreans by exploring the early arts. Korean pictorial arts have changed both in their appearance and feel, especially in their shapes since ancient times. Despite heavy influence from nearby China, this style of painting developed a unique Korean personality. Korean artists strive for faithful representations of nature with a minimum of embellishment. This ideal is especially evident in landscape painting. Korean landscape paintings show the simple beauty of nature through different shades of charcoal. The pieces feature plenty of open space, just as you would find in nature. Koreans also transformed writing into art. Stroke by stroke, character by character, they wrote with a brush as if painting a picture. Early Koreans used a version of Chinese characters. But once Hangul alphabet was created, it became clear that the nation's language was distinct from Chinese. Among Korea's traditional art genres, Buddhist art blossomed with the most colors and vividness. Tenghua, a type of painting, is a prime example. The smooth and elegant lines characteristic of Buddha drawings remain unique to this day. These two works are a testament to the dexterity of Korean hands. Dojagi, or ceramics, is a representative Korean traditional art. Since about 5000 BC, simple pottery served as dishes for food. Dojagi was born soon after when artists began to glaze their pottery until the 15th century. Korea and China were pioneers in world ceramics. Korean dojagi is unique because it retains its original mud or clay texture while displaying a crystal clear color. Various techniques and gorgeous patterns flourished on dojagi pieces, giving birth to a culture all its own. Dojagi is created through the melding of soil, water, and fire. Korean families used full moon-shaped jars during the 19th century. The shape and color of the jar resembled the full moon. What sets this jar apart from the other jars is that it is made in halves. Because the entire pot is too large to spin at once, the top and bottom halves are then joined. Glazing and whitening the dojagi is an important process. A thin application of the glaze preserves the texture while adding subtle shine. The thickness of the glaze determines the color of the pot. Intricate and elaborate white porcelain dojagi has been created since the 15th century. It looks simple at first glance, but grows more elegant with time. In a kiln full of fired clay pots, only a few will fully satisfy the potter. Despite the time and effort it takes to finish one piece, a potter will not hesitate to shatter those he considers imperfect. The rigor and austerity of dojagi artists help the pottery culture flourish. The moon-shaped jar, a piece famous for its all-encompassing abundant roundness. The slightly rolled edge of a moon-shaped jar's opening makes for a graceful silhouette. The piece balloons into a sphere immediately below the rolled edge, narrowing again past the widest center circumference. The piece is slightly asymmetrical, left to right. The visible line where the two halves were connected also adds a bulkiness to the piece. But these imperfections add to the simple beauty of the moon-shaped jar. Clay pots are first fired at low temperatures. Next, patterns are created with oxidized steel paint, which immediately add character to the white porcelain pot. The pots feature designs inspired by nature. Grapevines, bamboo, cranes, and apricots are some popular themes. Another type of porcelain pot features clear and blue patterns. After the patterns are created with cobalt paint, the pot is fired and glazed. The patterns are created with thick lines and cover nearly the entire surface of the pot. The finished product resembles a landscape painting. Craftsmanship of this level requires much time and effort.
Dojagi를 만드는 그러니까 하루 이틀이 되는 게 아니죠. 그런데 거기서 이제 만드는 것도 할 줄 알아야 되고 유약도 할 줄 알아야 되고 이제 그 흙도 만들 줄 알아. 그것이 다 맞아야 하나의 도자기가 되는 것이니까 한 가지만 해서는 안 되는 거고. 이제 그거를 배우려면 몇십 년이 걸려도 죽을 때까지 해도 못 다 배우는 거죠.
The beauty of paintings, dojagi, and arts and crafts. From kings to the nobility to the commoners, Korea's ancestors appreciated and created art firsthand. The innovation of its inventors and the international influence has continuously renewed and developed Korean traditional art. Traditional Korean music is considered to have originated from early religious ceremonies. Music sung during ancestral worship ceremonies has developed into a variety of forms. This musical evolution also influenced the creation of instruments. There are about 60 traditional Korean instruments. The creative personalities of Koreans have birthed distinct styles of national music. One popular form of traditional music is pansori. A story is told through song and prose along with the beat of a bass drum. The art shows how various types of sounds can be made with the human voice. For example, the sounds can resemble that of rain or animals. Pan means a yard or a court. It's where people would gather in olden days and where artists would express the public sentiments through performances. The poignancy of pansori relies heavily on the talent of its practitioners and on how well they can use their voices. That's why every pansori performer must make every effort to find the personality of his or her voice. People can practice and develop their vocal strength in caves or under waterfalls. It is said that good pansori performers are born through strenuous throat bleeding practice. Traditional Korean music contains the sounds of nature because its instruments arise from nature. The daegum clarinet is a wind instrument made of bamboo. It makes a clear and deeply resonant sound. It's a sound reminiscent of bamboo leaves and stems brushing against each other in a strong wind. The Kwanggari gong was inspired by the dramatic noise of thunder. The Kwanggari gong's impressive sound leads even the largest of symphonies. The summers in Korea are often drenched in sudden and heavy rains. This gave rise to the janggu drum. This particular drum was inspired by the steady pelting of rain. The gong is another instrument inspired by natural noises. Its sound resembles that of an ox. The sound of a gong lingers, offering a long, elusive echo. In fact, it has been measured to last as long as 9 waves. Korea's representative string instrument, the gayagum. A gayagum can be played by either plucking or flicking its 12 strings. A gayagum is unique for its elegant and soft sounds, which depend on its materials that it is. The upper board of the gayagum is made of paulownia wood, which takes a long time to mature in nature.
나무를 이제 제재를 한 상태에서 이제 5년 동안 눈비를 비바람 다 맞추면서 이제 진을 뺀다고 하죠. 이제 진을 빼서 이렇게 나쁜 것은 다 버리고 실질적으로 5년 동안 건조 상태에서 3분의 1 정도는 버립니다. 이 자체에서 뒤틀림도 많이 있고 예, 제대로 된 이게 자연에서 수용하는 것만 제작이 가능합니다.
Only wood that has survived the drying process can produce the sounds of a gayagum. Scorching the wood purifies it from resin and termites that have managed to survive 5 years of the drying process. This process prevents future distortion of the wood and perfects it as a gayagum material. All materials used to make a gayagum are completely natural. The wooden goose foot shaped string rests are hand carved. The most striking characteristic of Korean stringed instruments is their silk threads. Silk threads are natural materials from cocoons. The natural gayagum is designed not to work with artificial materials. The music of royal courts, ancestral worship, and other ceremonies are grand and solemn sounding. The calm and slow music induces a peaceful effect. Kings would listen to this music to take their minds off their work. Queens also listened to soothing palace music while they were pregnant. Today, palatial music is considered good for health and well-being. Shall we see just how good? Modern-day Koreans suffering from stress. Through meditation and mental training, a lot of people are taking care of their bodies and minds. Traditional Korean mind and body training methods emphasize the importance of taking deep breaths from the lower abdomen. Traditional Korean music has been shown to help in this process.
편안해지면서 그 마음이 여유로워질까요? 그러면서 이제 심신이 안정이 되면서 심파가 가라앉게 된다고 할까요? 그러면서 아주 평화롭게 자연스러운 그런 호흡으로 할 수 있다고 생각합니다.
According to the rules of physics, the type of sound wave most effective in helping the body and soul relax is the 1F wave. The sounds of nature are said to carry this wave. The waves in traditional Korean music resemble the soothing 1F wave.
근데 그런 F분의 1 흔들림은 사람에게 아주 편안한 감정을 유도해 준다는 사실을 이제 과학자들이 많이 그 증명을 했거든요. F분의 1 흔들림이라는 것은 그 예측하고 조금씩 빗나가지만 아주 크게 빗나가지 않고 아주 재밌게 집중력 있게 사람을 유도를 해주는 그런 특징을 가지고 있거든요. 그래서 이제 우리 국악 같은 데는 그런 F분의 1 흔들림 요소가 상당히 많이 들어 있습니다.
The waves in Mozart's music are said to have a relaxing effect, one that varies from that of the 1F wave. This particular wave is also entirely absent in dance music. The concepts in traditional Korean music combine nature with man. Because of this combination, music arising from nature is said to be pure and genuine. Instruments are made using resources from nature. Uncontrived sounds of rhythms combine for music that is utterly instinctive, improvised, and genuine. Instead of following sheet music to the T, the musicians improvise. By fully experiencing nature, one can appreciate traditional Korean music. Koreans like to dance. They dance when they're happy and when they're sad. They express their sorrows through dance as well. Research shows that Korea has about 370 different varieties of dance. That's how much Koreans love to dance. Traditional dance stems from both the common class and royalty. What are the special characteristics of these dances? A people's arts are widely influenced by natural surroundings. Considering Koreans have especially revered nature, its influence on the arts is particularly strong. Nature becomes a source of faith. Trees and rocks, which are eternal elements of nature, are seen to help protect families and the country as a whole. Songs and dances were used in man's effort to become one with the gods of nature. These practices later evolved into traditional Korean dance. Jindo, located in the southern part of the Korean peninsula. A Sikkimgut exorcism from Jindo, in which people prayed for spirits through song and dance, is a good example of dance's spiritual origins. During this ritual, people prayed for the dead to go to paradise. The process is believed to cleanse the spirit of grudges, sorrow, and negativity. The focus of the ritual involves rolling a person's clothes in a mat and cleansing them with three types of water and a broom. This signifies that the spirit of the dead can be cleansed and sent to paradise. The cleansing lasts an entire night and involves singing, dancing, and conversations. The individual who performs these tasks most successfully is considered the top exorcist. Dances performed at the Sikkimgut exorcism, minus the incantations, developed and became Korea's traditional Salpuri dance. Salpuri dance remains one of Korea's most popular folk dances. Once Salpuri dance was developed, it became a dance performed by gisaeng to entertain guests in the men's quarters of a house. Korean dance depicts emotions and it is not restricted to a specific form. People can dance in their own style. Among Korean dances, Salpuri is known to be the most impromptu. A person dances according to the mood of the day and also according to how the spectators respond. Fast music lightens and diversifies the dancers' moves. Scarves used during Salpuri dance create a mood of excitement as they swing and sail in the air. Traditional Korean dance expresses that which is both dynamic and passive. But there's still another form of artistic expression that can help you cope with everyday life. A means that involves humor and social criticism. It's the mask dance. Mask dance has developed in all regions of Korea. It is characterized by a sense of freedom and improvisation that depicts the essence of traditional Korean art. In a mask dance, there is no distinct separation between the audience and the performers. the audience is encouraged to express its reactions, which would then likely spur the performers to react back with improvised gestures. The Hahui mask dance was born out of conflict, from the clash between commoners wishing for freer and more natural self-expressions and the aristocrats trying to discourage that desire. So how did such a controversial performance, filled with contemptuous remarks about the aristocratic class, find its way to the stage? Every mask dance performance is impromptu and therefore unique. It's the dance of commoners, one that was practiced whenever people felt the natural urge to dance. Buddhism has greatly influenced Korean culture. In fact, it's accurate to say that the religion created masterpieces in nearly every genre of art, be it in sculptures, architecture, paintings, music, dance, and more. One dance that originated from Buddhism is called Sungmu, or the monk's dance. Like Salpuri, it has high artistic qualities and is valued as folk dance. Sungmu dance is filled with curvy lines. Long sleeves worn by dancers help create curved lines during dance. A dancer's sleeves can create big or small movements. The girth of a horizontal curve and the swoosh of sleeves toward the sky make the dance visually appealing. Singing and dancing were used to create an air of excitement at royal court banquets. The king would decide on the scale of the royal banquet according to the economy and harvest results of that year. The theme of royal court dances arose not from individual emotions, but instead from something larger. People would praise the merits of a late king or pray for the long life of the current king. In contrast to folk dances, this dance, while being graceful, adhered more to forms and rules. Also, the flow of the dance is distinctive for being dignified and elegant. Excitement, anticipation, and pleasure are essential parts of the Korean sentiment. Korean dance is a spontaneous depiction of this fundamental Korean emotion. This exhilarating dancing style serves as an outlet for stress and has been shown to rejuvenate any dancer. The basis of Korean dance is curved lines and an avoidance of sudden movements. the soft flow of a stream and the roundness of hilltops are embodied in dance. Traditional dance has recently been reborn in a fleshier, more exciting way. Through the creation of graceful lines and the joy of dance, the spirit of traditional Korean arts is resuscitated in modern times. Korean arts have flourished within Korea's rich culture and nature. Art has long been born through the reverence of nature and the cultivation of hope. After all, it's the universal element able to portray everything from seemingly inexpressible pleasure to sorrow. Art is saturated with life, its cycles of nature, its griefs, and of course, its joys. Korean artists have trained their bodies and souls to gain enlightenment. Their knowledge is embedded in their works. Art created in this way is simultaneously simple but refined, calm but constantly teeming with life. A profound respect for life has remained ingrained in art. That's why, for hundreds of years, the uniqueness of Korean art has sustained the essence of life.